over a 24-hour period, everything appears to rise from someplace in the east, transits at the meridian, and sets in the west. And the pattern just repeats itself over and over again. However, I'd like to show you something. You notice that I've chosen a particular date. It's December the 12th, 2015, and the time is at 12 noon. And I chose this date because from our position in Baltimore, the sun happened to be directly on the meridian at exactly 12 noon. Now, I'd like to call your attention to the moon, Mercury, and Saturn, and the sun, and you'll notice the rest are all stars. Antares is labeled for us. What we're going to do is allow the Earth to rotate around, okay? So we're going to make one complete revolution on our axis, and we're going to come back to this exact position with respect to the background stars. Let's do that now. Okay, we have now executed a sidereal day. It is exactly 23 hours and 56 minutes later, and you'll notice that the date is the 13th, and you notice that the time is 11:56. And the thing is that the stars are exactly where they were. You don't see a shift in the position of the stars. But notice that the sun and the moon, Mercury and Saturn, have all shifted eastward somewhat. Remember, east is on the left side of our screen, west is toward the right. And notice that the sun is not quite on the meridian. There's a little bit of a gap there. We have to let time tick forward. So let me direct your attention to the time here. We are at 11:56. Let's advance by 4 minutes. Now you see that the stars are shifting, but now we've got the sun back on the meridian. This is an example of a solar day, and it turns out it is exactly 24 hours. So what's really going on here? Well, let's think about it from a topside view of the Earth and Sun. So we have the Earth on the left, we have the Sun, and then on the far right edge of your screen, you'll notice that there's a line of stars. And the idea there is to represent the background, so-called fixed stars. So what we're going to do is allow the Earth to execute one rotation in its orbit around the Sun, but that means that as it's rotating, it's also orbiting. So that means it moves a little bit, and this is a sidereal day. You'll see that the arrow is pointed directly back toward the same background or fixed stars. This is the 23-hour, 56-minute period that we saw before. But you notice that we're not pointed at the sun yet. We have to rotate a little bit more, and in so doing, we move just a little bit farther along in our orbit. This causes the solar day to happen. In other words, we need an additional 4 minutes to face the sun, and this is why the sun appears to shift its position with respect to the background stars. Now, good for us, because we know enough about astronomy to build up this sort of picture. But to the ancient Greeks, it was very difficult to imagine anything other than the entire cosmos revolving around the Earth.